Hello, Honors Chemistry, and welcome to part two of the review, where we're going to work just a couple of sample problems from the back half of the review. So first of all, here is our nutrition info, right? Where really, it's kind of like those word problems that we did in the mixed practice and that you've done in other parts at this point, right? Where really all we're doing is extracting our own conversion factors, right? So for example, if we look at A, it asks us how many grams of protein are in 3 cups of cereal, right? So then what I decided to do was I looked over here and I saw that 1 cup of cereal, right, is equal to 2 grams of protein. And I wrote that down as my conversion factor. And then that's what I used with 3 cups being my given, right? So the concepts are still the same, that 3 cups of cereal are my given, grams of protein, and I need to come up with a conversion factor, right? Same thing in B, right? We have 100% daily value is my given of iron, right? And so here we have to be a little bit thoughtful in that we need to make sure that we're clear that we are talking about 100% daily value of iron, right? And I need to write a relationship between iron and the cereal, right? So it's important that now when we go to the nutrition facts label, we go find iron, right? 30% of iron is equal to 1 serving of cereal, right? 30% of iron is equal to 1 serving of cereal, and that becomes our conversion factor, right? So same stuff we've been doing. Now let's work out a couple of these just for practice, right? Let's see, here we have what mass of gold occupies 9 × 10⁵ millimeters cubed, right? So we would like to know the mass, this is our question, of gold, and we are given a volume. So now we have to solve using our given. So we'll take our 9 × 10⁵ millimeters cubed of gold, and then we've got to get our millimeters cubed to something that we can use with the density of gold. Well, the density of gold is 19.3 grams of gold are equal to 1 centimeter cubed of gold, which means we've got to get these millimeters cubed to centimeters cubed, right? And so this goes back to what we've done a whole bunch at this point, right? We are going to write the one-dimensional relationship between millimeters and centimeters. Which of these are bigger? Right. And there are 10 of these, right? And so now we need to turn it into a three-dimensional relationship, which means we are going to cube the entire conversion factor, right? Now, if keeping track of all the entry is tough for you in the calculator, go ahead and turn this into what it actually is, right? Like, go ahead and apply that 3 now, right? Where this would be 10³ millimeters cubed is equal to 1 centimeter cubed, right? That's what the relationship turns into, and that's what we can put in here, right? So 10³ millimeters cubed is equal to 1 centimeter cubed, right? And then those cancel, right? And then we can use our density, which says that 19.3 grams are equal to 1 centimeter cubed. Those cancel, and then we simply get the final answer and round, okay? Likewise, if we go down a little bit further, right, and we get some of these questions down here, right? So, for example, it says a cube of aluminum has a mass of this, and what are the dimensions, right? Then we'd have to think back to ourselves, what is the significance of the word cube, right? Typically, length times width times height is equal to volume, but if it's a cube, length equals width equals height, right? Therefore, right, length cubed is equal to volume for a cube, right? So if I would like to know the dimensions, that means I'm going to start from my mass, which is my given, and then I'm just going to have to convert to, right, volume is my unknown, volume first, and then dimensions, then my length, right? So we're going to start with our 1.3824 kilograms of aluminum, right? And then we'll go get the density, which says 2.7 grams are equal to 1 centimeter cubed. And then we'll go ahead and do our work, right? Ah, kilograms, you got to turn that into grams. So let's write that one down to 1 kilogram, because that's bigger, are equal to 10³ grams, right? So 1 kilogram, 10³ grams, and then 2.7 grams are equal to 1 centimeter cubed, right? And this is going to give us our volume, right? We get a volume of 512 centimeters cubed. And then if I know that length cubed is equal to volume, then length cubed is equal to 512 centimeters cubed, right? And then what I'm going to do in terms of math, I'm just going to take both sides and raise them to the 1/3 power, right? And so when I take 3 raised to the 1/3, I end up with length. And when I take this, right, I'm going to do the cubed root of 12. So for me, I'm just going to type in 512 to the 1/3 because that's what I prefer. And when I uncube centimeters, I end up with centimeters, right? So do be mindful about your units. Same thing we've been doing, right? Our units now are an integral part of everything, right? So the same operations apply. All right. And then on the last page, again, we're just extracting our conversion factors from the recipe that we're given, right? So for example, 8 crepes, right, are equal to 2 eggs, right? Because those things go together, right? 1 pound of flour, and I'd like to know how many crepes I can make. Well, then I need to come up with a relationship for that, right? Well, it turns out that 100 grams of flour are equal to 8 crepes, right? And that's my relationship. So I'm going to start with my 1 pound, get my pounds to grams, and then I can use this conversion factor, right? All right. Make sure you study. Make sure you know the things you're supposed to memorize, like those 4 English metric conversions along with your prefix table and, well, of course, the elements and the safety rules, right? So make sure you know all these things and have a wonderful day. Thank you for listening. Be good, and I will see you soon. Bye.